Education Online Program. With you is teacher Willa Lucia, taking you through physics. And our topic will be pressure. So under this pressure, we shall be learning about pressure in solid. But then you're seeing this pressure in solid. You cannot just go to pressure in solid without you knowing what pressure is. How would you define pressure? Let us take an example of you cutting a fruit using a knife. So you have your fruit. You want to cut this fruit. The knife has sides. It has the blunt side and then it has the sharper side. The sharper side is very small, having very small area than the blunt side. That means that when you put the sharper side on the fruit, you can easily cut your fruit. But then if you use the blunt side, the fruit will not be cut that easily. Why? This is because of the area of the knife. If the area is huge, that means that the pressure you are going to apply is small. That's why you find it very hard for the fruit to be cut through. So to define pressure from this example, our pressure will be defined as, is the force acting normally per unit area. So whenever you're defining pressure, you make sure you do not leave out this term here. This word normally carries a very big meaning in the definition. So you always have to put it in. So you see this pressure here, it is a scalar quantity. Why is it a scalar quantity? This is because pressure has only the magnitude without the direction. For example, look at smoke. When there is a smoke coming out of something, what happens is that the smoke does not look for a specific direction to take, but then it moves just randomly. It takes any direction. That's why we are saying that it doesn't have specific direction. It carries only the magnitude. So this pressure here has SI unit. What is the SI unit of pressure? The SI unit of pressure is newtons per square meters. Which you can also write as capital N because it is a name of a person, per square meters. But it is not the only SI unit of pressure. Pressure can also be measured in pascals or pascals, which is abbreviated as P and then a small a. So these are the two SI units of pressure. They are two because this one newton per meter squared is equivalent to one pascals. That's why it is the same. So if you now know the pressure definition of pressure and then the SI unit of pressure, let us go back to solid pressure. So if it is now solid pressure, why do you think we have solid has pressure? What causes this pressure in solid? This is because solid has got also molecules, but in this case the molecules in solid are not in random motion, but they are compact together, which means that if our pressure is defined as the force acting normally per unit area, the pressure a solid substance will exert on any other object will be its weight. Okay, so if it is its weight, let us see, solid exerts its weight as the pressure on other objects. If it exerts its weight on other pressure, then how would you find out, how would you calculate the pressure in the solid? So to calculate the pressure in solid, we have a formula that we use, and the formula, you get it from the definition, what is pressure. So if this is the definition, that means that to get pressure in solid, you'll write your pressure, which is P, is equals to, we are saying it is the force, that means it equals to the force acting normally per unit area. That means you divide this by the area it is covering. So in this, you see that our pressure is measured in what? Our pressure is measured in Newton per square meter. The force, which is F, is measured in newtons. Then we have the area, which is A, is measured in meters squared, or you can say square meters in words. Square meters. So that is our formula for finding pressure in solid. So you see that this pressure in solid, if this is the formula, what are the factors that affect this pressure in solid? So we have the factors affecting pressure in solid. So let's take a look at this example. You have your parent and you're a child. Imagine the weight of your father or mother is greater than yours. So you have a swinging, okay, so you have a tree. On this tree, the tree has got branches. You come and tie a rope on this branch. You want to play a game. You, the child, you come and sit. Then your parent will be swinging you on this rope. What happens is that you will be swinging to and fro, minus this branch falling down, or minus this branch breaking. But then you come down and let your parent also go on the branch. There is high chances that this branch will easily break down. Why? This is because when you sat here and you were swinging, your weight is not as big as your parents' weight. But then also the area here can support your weight than your parents' weight. That's why you find when it is your parent, in this case, the branch can easily break. That means that the factors that affect pressure can be the area. So if we are looking at the factors affecting pressure in solid, we say one of the factors
is the area of contact. How does the area of contact affect pressure in solid? You see that when the area of contact is big, that means that our pressure is going to be reduced. And if the area, if the area is big, the pressure will be reduced. Why? Because if you come back to the formula of finding pressure in solid, you see that the area is inversely proportional to pressure. That means that every time you increase this area, that means the pressure will be reduced. Okay? So if you increase our pressure here, that means our area here is also going to be affected a bit. So this explains also why a woman in heels can easily sink down in muddy area than an elephant, even though the elephant is heavier than the heels, or the person wearing the heels. This is because the feet of an elephant is having a wider area that it covers on the floor. Okay, so if this area is wide like this, we are assuming that this is the feet of our elephant, and then look at a lady here wearing heels, and the heel, my shoe looks terrible, but it's okay. So this is our shoe. The heels, you know how these heels look like? They are very sharp down. When you step in the mud, this heel here, the area it's going to cover, the surface area is very small. That's why you find out that this lady will sink in the mud than this elephant, because of the big surface area it will cover on the floor. So let's look at our next factor that affects pressure in solid. Our next factor is the force. The force applied. How big is your force that you're applying on any object? Because this force you're applying will depend, it will depend on how much pressure you're going to get. That means that when you have, we talked of a fruit, cutting a fruit, we can have that sharp end, yes, but then how much force have we applied on it so that it can cut through the fruit? So the larger amount of force you apply on an object will also increase the pressure in the object is producing. That's why if you look at our formula there, our pressure is directly proportional to the force you apply. That means that whenever you increase force, the pressure is going to be automatically increased. So whenever you also reduced the force, the pressure will automatically be reduced, which is a different case, of course, with the area. We already looked at that. So if you already know the factors affecting this pressure in solid, then how will you find pressure in solid? Let's look at how to calculate this pressure using the formula we've written on the whiteboard. Let's look at example one. So if we have a question saying a man of mass 884 kilogram stands upright
on a floor, on a floor, if the area, if the area of contact of his shoes and the floor if the area of contact of his shoe and the floor is 420 centimeters squared, find the pressure exerted on the floor, on the floor by the man. Okay, then let's take a look at this example here. We are saying that a man of mass 84 kilogram stands upright on the floor if the area of contact of his shoe and the floor is 420 centimeters squared. Find the pressure exerted on the floor by the man. For you to find this pressure here, you first try to summarize your question. What have they given you in the question, and what is it that they want you to find in the question? Let's look at this. What are those things that have been given to us in the question? A man of mass 84 kilogram. In our question, we have the mass of the man, which is given as 84 kilogram, stands upright a floor if the area of contact of his shoe, area of contact, this makes, this is another thing that has been given to us, the area of contact. That means our area of contact here is 420 centimeters squared. Find the pressure exerted on the floor by the man. So what we are trying to find here is now the pressure. So for you to find the pressure, we know that from our formula now, our pressure is equals to force over area. They have given us the area, yes? They have given us the mass, but they haven't given us the force directly. So what you have to do is, you need to first find the force. You can find the force from the mass, because we said a solid object exerts a pressure which is its weight also. So that means that the force and a solid object is exerting is its weight. Now means to find the force here, force will be equals to our weight. And what, how do you find weight? To get weight, weight is equals to mass and acceleration due to gravity, which is g. We know our acceleration due to gravity is given as always as 10. It is 9.81, but you can round it off to 10. So to get your force, we'll give you our weight, which is mg. But in this case, our mass was already given as 84. And we know that our acceleration due to gravity is 10. So we can find our force is equals to the mass, which is 84, times acceleration due to gravity, which is 10, to give us our force is equals to, so 84 times 10, what will it give us? It will give us 840, and our force is measured in what? In newtons. Whenever you are doing your calculations, never forget the SI unit, Because this SI unit, if you leave it out, it makes your answer become wrong. Now we have found our force. So if we have our force as 840, let's see if we put it in our formula here, how will it look like? So our force here, our pressure will be equals to the force, which is 840 over our area A. We have not included this area because the area has not been given the SI unit. You can see that it's not the standard SI unit for finding area. So what is that standard unit for standard unit for area? It is meters squared. So we have to convert this 420 centimeters squared to meters squared. So we shall have our area, but our area is equals to, so there we having 420 centimeters squared. How do you change, convert centimeters squared to meters squared? Because we know our one meter is equals to what? Our 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeters. This is meter and this is centimeter, but it is not centimeters squared. So you have to find it in meters and centimeters squared. To find it in centimeters and meters squared, come here and square this. You come and square that. So you'll get that this will be 1 squared and meters squared is equals to 100. We are removing the brackets. 100 squared, and then our centimeters is also now squared. So you'll see that 1 squared will give us 1 meters squared, and 100, when you square 100, what do you get? That is the same as 100 times 100, which will give us 10. It will give us 10,000 meters. Okay, sorry, this is centimeters squared. That means that in every one meter squared, we have 10,000 centimeters squared. But then in our question, they have given us our area in centimeters squared, so we have to convert it to meters. So if 1 meter squared is equals to 10,000 centimeters squared, what will happen to 420 centimeters squared? How many meters will be in that? So we shall have here as our x. What you do now is you cross multiply. You'll have your x times 10,000. 10,000 times x is equals to our 1 times 420. So if we have that, this will give us 10,000 x is equals to 420 is equals to 420, because any number multiplied by 1 is that number itself. So what we are trying to find is x in meters squared, because you already have the centimeters squared, which is 420. So you go and divide this by 10,000, and then divide here by 10,000. This will cross with that. We shall be left with x this side is equals to, we shall cross this and that. We are going to get a decimal. How will you get the decimal? When you cross this zero, take your decimal from there here. So with one, when you cross 10, we shall have 4.2. What if you cross this zero? You carry your decimal from this point here. So this will give you 0.42. Now we have this. When you cross this, another decimal, which will give you 0.042 meters squared. That means that our 420 centimeters squared is equivalent to 0.042 meters squared. So now there we have got our
our area with its standard unit. You bring your area and now substitute it in your formula. Our P is equals to 840 over what? 0.0442. So if you have it like that, then if you get the calculation of this, it will give us in our pressure is measured in meters, Newton meter squared. So you'll have our pressure is equals to what? If you calculate 400 divide by that, you're going to get, if you divide 840 divide by 0.042, you will get your pressure as 20,000 Newton per meter squared. So this is how you find the, you get the calculation. This is how you do the calculation for solid in, pressure in solid, I mean. So now we have seen how to use our formula there and how to convert from centimeters squared to meters squared. If you have this way, you have to convert a lot. Now let us see another one example before we go to the next. What is the next? Let's see this. We have, let's look at example two. They're telling us a metallic block of mass 400, a metallic block of mass 40 kilogram. Exerts a pressure of 20 Newton per meter squared on a surface. Find the area. Find the area of contact. We are finding the area of contact between the block, between the block and the surface. The block and the surface. In this case, they are telling us to find the area. In the first example, you were trying to find the pressure the man's shoe exerts on the floor. But this time, you want to find the area. How would you find the area? So in our question, what has been given? We have a metallic block of mass. So our mass was given as 40 kilogram. The pressure the metallic block exerts is 20 Newton per meter squared on a surface. So we don't know how large the surface is or how small. So let us try to find out, because it's what we want to find, the area. So to find this, you see that in this example, everything has already been given to you in the standard units. So you do not have to go ahead and do all the conversion from one unit to another. Because here, our mass is measured in kilogram, which is the standard unit, and the pressure is already in Newton per meter squared. So what is the area? You also come again and apply your formula, which is pressure is equals to force over area. Do we have the force? No, but we have the mass. So we can get the force from the mass, because the force is the same as the weight. So our force is equals to mg. What is m? M is 40 times our g, which is 10. We shall have our force is equals to 40 times 10, which will give us 400 newtons. So you just come now and take your force, what you've calculated, you substitute it in your formula to give you pressure is equals to the force which you've calculated and found it as 400 newtons, divide by the area which has not been given. It is the area we are finding. So we have our area, we don't have, but the pressure has been given to you as 20. So you'll have your 20 is equals to 400 over the area. You divide this by 1, because here you have not changed anything. You cross multiply. So when you cross multiply, what will happen is that you'll get 20A, you'll have your 20A is equals to 400. You divide it by the coefficient of the area, which is 20, and then this will cancel. Your area will be given to you as, this will cancel, and 40 divided by 2, 2 will go here once, 2 will go into 4 twice. So our area of contact is 20 meters squared. So I hope you've got how to find the pressure in solid, and then even though they have given you the area, they have not given you the area, you're in position to find the area. Sometimes it is the force which is not being given. You're also told to find that. But as long as you know the formula and you know what has been given in the question, that would be very easy for you to find, to do your calculations. So with pressure, the major thing you have to know is you need to know the definition of pressure. If you know the definition of pressure, then it is fine. You need to know the formula of finding pressure in solid, which is P is equals to F over A. And then what are those factors that pressure in solid depend on, which is the area of contact and the force applied. So you need to keep those ones at your fingertips anytime. And since we have finished our calculation, let us look at this trial question. I'm giving you some questions, then you can go ahead and try. I will give you the answers so that you see when you calculate, you will know that your answer is correct. So this is our exercise. We have it as the dimensions of a cuboid these are the dimensions of this cuboid, which is 5 cm by 10 cm. Then by 2 cm, and weight, this is the weight of our cuboid, of the cuboid, is 60 newton. Calculate Roman 1, maximum pressure. And then we have Roman 2, minimum pressure. So those are that is the question I'm leaving you with. When you're calculating the maximum pressure, make sure you get your answer as, your answer should be 12,000 pascals, and then the minimum pressure, the answer is 3,000 pascals. You go and try this out and check if your answer is correct. So with this, we've come to the end of our lesson for today, and we shall meet again for the next lesson.